Welcome to Cooking Counter with Shea. Shea, what are you making?
Eggs and cinnamon rolls.
Nice. From scratch?
As opposed to your store-bought egg recipe. Your little egg kit.
So the eggs are from scratch.
Yes.
Okay, cool.
I don't know why you felt the need to call me out on cinnamon rolls, but fine.
A couple of people have asked why we only vlog in the car, so...
So to show you that we do, in fact, live in a house, we're going to vlog in the house today. Of course, this isn't our house, we just...
We're squatting.
We're squatting.
What is your favorite kind of egg?
chicken.
Oh, wow. That's a bit fancy.
I've never had quail eggs, though, I can't...
Can you imagine how many you'd need?
How many quail eggs?
How many eggs would you like? 19 should do.
19, because they're fucking quail eggs.
I am going to be asking Shay some questions, just chatting and whatnot. So today is Halloween. If you had to go to a Halloween party, what would you have dressed up as?
Gomez Adams.
That would have been cool. I wanted to be Cruella de Vil. I'll have to save it for next year. All right, so next question. Do you like to cook?
Yeah, I do.
What's your favorite thing to cook?
I really love doing omelets.
Oh, well, that's perfect.
I know that they're like super... No, I didn't make omelets. scrambled eggs.
Let's pretend that this is like one of those dating shows, right? So what is your perfect date? We'll say it's an evening date.
Oh, man, you want to stay in and play some video games? It's a pandemic, after all.
Well, pretend it isn't. Would you still want to do that?
Oh, no. I had this one first date where, I picked him up at, like, 2 a.m.
Yeah.
we went to a cemetery.
And it was a date.
Yeah. Just kind of hung out for a little while, and then he stole one of my sweatshirts. And we went to McDonald's for breakfast.
Because nothing makes you want to eat more than being around cemetery at night.
At that point, it was like 7 a.m.
You gotta pull the thing. Oh, Jesus Christ. All right. Those frighten me. We'll stick with a couple fun dating questions. So what are some, like, deal breakers for you? Or, like, red flag type action on a first date?
Staying the night. Unless I ask you to. Okay. You just, like, kind of try to insert yourself into my home. That's a bad sign. That's a big, big no-no for me.
If somebody else was planning the date, what is something that you would really, like, hate doing?
Oh, hate doing?
Yeah. Like, if they were like, okay, I have a surprise and drove you somewhere or whatever, and it was just like...
to a concert on a first date.
That makes sense. You can't really talk to each other.
I'm a different human being in a concert than I am in my regular life. And if we're just getting to know each other, then a concert is not the place for it.
Gotcha. What if it was like a Keith Urban concert? No offense to those who like
it. I guess I forgot to mention that in my red flags, but that's one of them.
What has been your favorite vacation?
So, anytime that I get to see my, like, adult siblings, I mean, all of them, but specifically the adult ones, and we can just kind of hang out together, it's been good. Last year, we went to Ocean City, Maryland, and then everybody was up for Christmas, which was really nice. Those are really fun.
Thank you for breakfast. Mm-hmm.
Almost one.
Thank you for lunch. Beer and eggs. The lunch of champions. What was your least favorite job?
I worked at a gym for a little while.
Really?
Yeah. I worked with like a children's sports program. It's like a sports complex, I think would be the way, like a better way to describe it. My boss was a nightmare there. Just, like, on my ass all the time. And, like, I was in college, like, working another job also. And, like, she just didn't seem to understand that. Like, I wasn't going to kill myself for a $7.50 an hour job.
Yeah, I don't think they care. They're just like, while you're here, you're ours.
She was insane.
I told my boss once because they wanted me to stay later. And I, not that I had anything to do, but I was just like, no. He was like, well, don't you care about it? And I was just like, no. Like,
no.
I work to live. I don't live to work. Why? That seems to be like a... Now, don't get me wrong. I've had some, like, really good bosses, but I would say that the majority of them are kind of like these...
Oh, my God. I'm sorry. I'm
asshole types.
Thinking about that conversation, and, like, one of the questions he asked me was, like, do you want to work here? And I was like, no.
I know.
No. You ask anybody on this team, no, they don't want to work here, but they have to work here. Like,
that's what makes me kind of chuckle about interviews, when they're like, why do you want to work here? It's like, because I have bills to pay and I need money.
Right, because it's not free but you
gotta,
to live in
but
an
But you
got to
be like, well, I researched your company and I think that your agenda and your, you know, is really, why do I want to work at a... because the coffee discount, like, come on, you know, maybe that's the thing. Their mission is to make money. And so is mine.
Right. Like, you know? I don't understand why you can have a goal to make money and I can't.
Yeah. Like, yeah. Why you have to have some sort of sentimental connection to a retail store.
Me thinking too much about my worth is not a, like, is a red flag to you. Like, that's not a company that I want to work for.
Yeah. Okay. So what has been your, we'll say excluding this job, mm-hmm. like your current job, what has been your favorite job?
I worked at, like, a mom and pop's, like, cafe kind of thing for a couple years. It wasn't, like, great, but they paid me better than they should have, and it was, like, fun. There was, like, 7 people, so, like, that was, like, the cool thing was that, like, you know, all of us were, a tangibly valuable member of the team.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? Like, we had to get this much stuff out, and, like, we all did it. You know what I mean?
Yeah. I worked at a bar at one point. All of the people working there were near the same age. And they were just all these, like, weird little, like, misfits, you know? And they all had these different hobbies and these weird personalities and fun senses of humor. And, like, it was fun because... And you actually enjoyed the people. Like, afterwards, you'd help everybody clean up. And then you'd go meet at someone's house and, like, just have a fun night, you know?
Little man. It's kind of disappointing.
They look good. Okay, well, let's just do some, like, fun facts. If you could change your name, what name would you pick? Like, I'm looking for, like, a stage name.
I'd probably, like, be, like, one of those mononym celebrities. Probably just be Shea.
Oh, okay. What would you pick for your drag name? It's supposed to be the, name of your first pet and the first street you lived on. So mine would be George the 12th. Thank you.
Sasha Sycamore.
That's nice. Shit, go with that one. So, back to Halloween. Looking back on costumes that you had when you were younger, what would you say is, like, your favorite one or the most embarrassing one? Or, like, just name one that you want to talk about.
Literally didn't have a costume idea on October 30th. And so, my older sister taped a bunch of, like, playing cards to me. And I went as a deck of cards. We did, like, I think I had, like, the heart over this eye and, like, the spade over this eye.
How did you see?
Like, painted on.
Oh, well, you said that she taped a bunch of cards to you, so
yeah,
I thought
but
she
not
taped
to
them
my
on.
Eyes. It was nice at the beginning, and then they just started to fall off.
Trick-or-treating. What is the weirdest thing that you got?
There was a dentist in our neighborhood that gave out dental floss.
Favorite scary movie.
Nightmare on Elm Street. Pretty scary. Also young Johnny Depp.
Mm. Gorgeous.
And the blood fountain.
Oh, you know what? We should do the plant thing.
It's time to hear about Fisher's plant. And his name is Plant.
Hello, friends, and welcome to another episode of Fisher's Plant. Plant is still the same. Thanks for watching. Thanks for watching Fisher's Plant. We hope to see you next time, but So, that's it, right?
Mm-hmm.
All right.
All right.
Bye.
Bye.